When I'm designing an art lesson, there are four things that I'm trying to incorporate. One will be the idea, what it is that I want to create. I might get that from a museum or from an internet website. The second thing is incorporating my art content, whether it's color mixing, art history, or something like that. Then I need to consider my student. How can I incorporate their point of view or their interests into what it is that they're creating so we avoid cookie cutter kinds of projects? And then core content, because we are teaching in a public school system and we want all of our students to succeed. There's generally going to be a product, a thing that's made, put on display, graded, taken home. Sometimes it'll be more ephemeral, like an Andrew Goldsworthy installation, but most things are going to be taken home. But though the product is the thing that we see, the process is the most important thing and the enduring thing that's going to happen with our students. 98% of kids are not going to be going on to an art-related career, and we need to teach all of them, not just that 2%. So these lifelong learning skills might end up showing up in your learning target. Things like students will be able to mix secondary colors from primary colors, or students will be able to compose an image based on the golden ratio. These kinds of things will translate into other content areas and be helpful in their learning. So one example I use is that every Monday my students come in and they respond to a famous quote about art or by a famous artist. They read it, they write down their interpretation of it, we share it, and then we move on. At the end of the year, students get to look up or find a famous quote about art, and then they illustrate it using any materials that I've made available to them throughout the year. So there's a lot of choice involved. They get to choose the quote, and they get to choose the media. So I've found that these kinds of projects are a way to really instill uniqueness and, again, avoid that cookie cutter. For my art quote kind of project, you could see that the art concept connections are going to be the composition. There's going to be color theory and how they're putting it together, the elements and principles like balance, contrast, unity, etc. These are all going to be incorporated into that project, and I'm going to make sure that I hit on those as I build the lesson. When I'm talking about the student, they're having choice in maybe picking a quote from a culture or from a famous person that they admire, something positive. It could be an art quote. I've done that many times, but I've also done it from, students' favorite heroes. So that builds in that level of choice into the project so that not two projects come out the same way. And that's really important to what it is that we're doing. So making those personal connections are going to help the student actually buy into the project and really enjoy and care about what it is that they're creating. The core connections are going to be different depending on the project, and with the quotes, then we're definitely making connections to reading and writing, which are important for CAT exams and SATs and things like that. There's some research involved in that and use of technology, so that would be a core connection. There is career connections possibly when you're talking about illustration as a potential career choice. If they're picking quotes from scientists, historical figures, mathematicians, which you could ask them to do, then there are more connections that you could be making to the core content, which I think would be really important and something your colleagues would appreciate. So you can see when we combine all four of these parts, we come up with some really amazing explorations in art. And some of these examples you can see behind me here. This one, more of a cultural one, where students had to look up a cultural hero or a personal hero. So there are ways to make these very personalized and unique. So again, you don't end up with all that cookie cutter kind of stuff. So if you'd like to learn more, you can look at my blog at www.artedguru.com, and you'll find lots of really cool stuff and choice-based explorations in art. Thank you.